Hi there, welcome back to the channel. My name is Rupak and this video is all about getting your handy dandy Arduino serial monitor on your mobile device using Bluetooth Low Energy or BLE. Now this method works for both Android and iOS devices without the need to change the existing hardware of your project. This method supports a variety of microcontrollers including the brand new Arduino Uno R4 Wi-Fi, the Raspberry Pi Pico Wi-Fi, the ESP32 chips, and in fact, you can use a Bluetooth Low Energy module like the HM10 module, which can replace the classical Bluetooth modules like the HC05. You can use these modules with the MCUs that do not have a native support for BLE. This video will cover the entire setup process, so let's get right into it. So first of all, I would like you to visit the GitHub repository for the project, and the link is in the description box. Here you'll find some useful information, the key features, the list of working devices, and in this video I'll be showing you how to use all the four working devices. Further upon scrolling, you'll find some example codes, two QR codes along with the links to download the app from the App Store and Google Play Store. So go ahead and install the app on your respective device. And once you have done that, I would like you to download the zip file for the GitHub repository. Go ahead and unzip the zip file. We'll first be touching base with the Arduino Uno R4 Wi-Fi board. So go ahead and attach it to your PC. Now open the Arduino folder and here you'll find a zip file called Arduino BLE. This is essentially a modified version of the original Arduino BLE library. One thing to note here is that you need to specifically use this modified version of the library. If you already have the original Arduino BLE library installed, then I would suggest you to remove or uninstall it before proceeding and install this zip library to the Arduino IDE. Now, if you're not familiar with installing zip libraries, just bear with me for a moment and I'll show you how to do that. You'll also see two more folders here. One folder is called the serial monitor and we'll be dealing with that today. The other one is called Steer Freely. Steer Freely is a mode in the mobile app that lets you control or steer your moving robots using BLE with a graphical user interface. I'll be making a separate video on that and today we'll just be focusing on the serial monitor. You'll find our Arduino file inside the serial monitor folder. Just go ahead and open that, and this should contain the entire starter code to get the serial monitor working with our mobile app. I will give you a quick rundown on what this code is doing. We are essentially defining a service and a characteristic with these three properties, which lets our remote device, which is going to be the mobile device in our case, to read, write, and notify. You can choose to replace the write without response with write with response, and you can also replace the BLE notify with BLE indicate if required. But if you're not familiar with the properties here, then you can just leave the code as is and it should just work fine. We give our Arduino device a local and a device name, which is called Weibel, and this is also the name of the app. So when we'll be looking for or searching for devices inside the app, our Arduino device should appear with the name of Weibel. The main idea here is that we have a counter value which gets incremented every 1 second, and the counter value gets displayed inside the mobile app. We also have the option to send a string from the mobile device which would be printed here on the serial monitor of the PC. The main idea of the starter code remains the same for all the boards and modules that I'm going to show in this video. The code, however, could look different for all the boards, but all the codes are well documented and you should be easily able to understand and incorporate them in your existing projects. I would now try to compile the code, and right away we see an error which says the Arduino BLE library is missing. Now you may or may not get this error. If you already have the Arduino BLE library installed, you'll get this error which will ask you to install the modified version of the BLE library from this link, And this link will essentially take you back to the zip file that I showed you a couple of moments ago. So all you need to do is just install the modified version of the Arduino BLE library using that zip file, and the error should go away. So I'll just show you how to do that. Go to Sketch, Include Library, add .zip library, and locate that zip file. Now the correct library has been installed, and now upon compiling, we are no longer getting that error message, and we are ready to upload the code to the Arduino board. After uploading the code, open the serial monitor at 9600 baud rate, and our device is ready to connect to our mobile device. Open the Wible app on your mobile device. When you're opening the app for the first time, it might request you for Bluetooth permissions. After granting the permissions, just select Serial Monitor, and you should be able to see the listing as Wible, which represents our Arduino device. Just go ahead and select that. And right away, we start seeing the counter values getting displayed on our mobile phone. We can also send strings back to the Arduino board, which will be displayed on the serial monitor on the PC. So this is how the Wible app works. And inside the app, you also have the same options that you get on the native serial monitor inside the Arduino IDE. I can choose to turn off or on the auto scrolling feature. I can also enable or disable timestamps. I can clear the serial monitor and also copy all the data inside the serial monitor. And with this, we are done with the tutorial for the Arduino Uno R4 Wi-Fi board. And next, we'll be switching to the ESP32 board. We are ready to deal with the ESP32 chip, so go ahead and attach it to your PC. Open the ESP32 folder. And as I said before, we'll just be dealing with the serial monitor today, so go ahead and open the serial monitor file. Again, the basic idea here is to have a counter value that increments every 1 second, and the value gets displayed on the mobile device, and whatever is sent from the mobile device will be displayed on the serial monitor on the PC. So before uploading the code, I'll again try to compile it. So as you can see, we are getting an error. And this error is due to a conflict with the Arduino BLE library that we installed earlier. So all you need to do to get rid of the error is to remove the Arduino BLE library. And now if I compile again, we should not be getting that error. So now we are ready to upload the code. Once the code has been uploaded, we'll open the serial monitor. But this time we'll set the baud rate to be 115200. The device is ready to connect. And now we'll open the Wible app on our mobile phone. Select serial monitor. The device should be listed as Wible. The counter values start appearing as soon as the connection is established. We can also send strings back to the ESP32 chip. And as you can see, the strings we sent from the mobile device appeared on the serial monitor on the PC. With this, the tutorial for ESP32 is over, and now we are ready to move on to the HM10BLE module. Start by opening the HM10BLE module folder. There you'll find a wiring diagram that shows how to attach the HM10 module to an Arduino board that does not natively support BLE. Simply connect the power lines of the HM10 module with the power lines of the Arduino board. The transmit pin from the HM10 module goes to digital pin 2 on the Arduino board. The receive pin from the HM10 module goes to digital pin 3 on the Arduino board. Also connect the Arduino board itself to the PC. Once the wiring is complete, open the serial monitor folder and then the serial monitor code. This code is well commented and it's fairly simple to understand. I've also included the wiring setup inside the code. Again, the basic idea stays the same. We have a counter that keeps incrementing every 1 second, and the counter value keeps displaying inside the mobile app. And whatever string we send from the mobile phone gets displayed onto the serial monitor on the PC. You can simply select your board and upload the code. Once the code has been uploaded, open the serial monitor at 9600 baud rate. Open the Vibble app on the mobile phone. Select serial monitor. And then select the BLE module. In our case, it's called HMSoft. The counter values are appearing on the mobile phone as expected. Let's send some strings back to the module. You may notice significant latency in the communication with this module, and that's why I would suggest you to stick with the other three boards shown in the video. The tutorial for the HM10 module is now complete, and we are only left with the Raspberry Pi Pico W. But before jumping onto it, I have something amazing for you guys. I have engineered a development board based on the ESP32C6 to simplify daily prototyping by integrating essential components to streamline your projects and reduce wiring mess. At its core is the ESP32C6 mini chip, which features Wi-Fi 6 and BLE 5.0 support for next generation connectivity. The board includes built-in dual high power PWM motor drivers, capable of handling up to 28 volts at 3.6 amps. It also comes with addressable LEDs that can function as status indicators or display dynamic animations. For programming, it features USB-C port for convenience. Power input options include DC power jack and screw terminal connections, both supporting up to 28 volts. To ensure stable power, the board integrates a 3.3 volt regulator for the MCU and an additional 5 volt 3 amp regulator to support external modules. A quick port is included for seamless integration of sensors and accessory boards. This port supports both Vibble and Arduino IDE out of the box. Its compact design features no components on the bottom, and a QR code on the board directs you to a website with detailed specification, an Arduino integration guide, and example codes. You'll also find a link to purchase the board there, which I'll include in the description box below. Please note I'm only selling surplus units from production and don't plan to make this a business venture as of now. So if you're interested, make sure to grab one before they sell out. Now coming back to the Raspberry Pi Pico W, we need to first install MicroPython to the board before we could flash the code for the serial monitor. This is a one-time process, and if you have already flashed MicroPython to your board, you can skip this section of the video. To install MicroPython, you need to press and hold the boot select button on the board while you plug in the USB cable. This will mount a removable drive on your PC. Simply open the Vibble code template, go to Raspberry Pi Pico W, and then drag and drop the UTF file into the newly mounted drive.
Now once you do that, the drive will be automatically ejected. And just for sanity, what I do is I remove the USB cable from Raspberry Pi Pico and I plug it back, but this time I won't be pressing the button. You will no longer see the mounted drive again when you plug in the board for the second time.
You need to install the Thony IDE in order to program the Raspberry Pi Pico. There are other ways to program the board as well, for example using a VS Code extension, but for this video I'll be sticking to the Thony IDE. So go ahead, download, install and open the Thony IDE. On the bottom right you can see the IDE has detected the Raspberry Pi Pico board. Go ahead and navigate to the Weibel Core Template folder and open the Raspberry Pi Pico W directory. Open the serial monitor directory and here you'll find three Python files. One by one, right click on each Python file and select upload to slash. What this is essentially doing is it's just copying the Python files to the Raspberry Pi Pico. Once you have done it for all three Python files, just double click the main.python file inside Raspberry Pi Pico. Click on the run button. As soon as you hit the run button, you'll see the LED on the Raspberry Pi Pico starts flashing. Now you don't need to go through this entire process to get the board running once you have already programmed it. After programming the board once, you just need to power the board and it will automatically start executing the main.py file. Now for the one last time, open the Weibel app, select serial monitor and select Weibel. As soon as the board gets connected, you'll see the counter values appearing on your phone. The LED on the Raspberry Pi Pico stops flashing and you can send messages back from your phone to the Raspberry Pi Pico. As you can see, this is working.
With this, we have wrapped up the tutorial for the Raspberry Pi Pico W. If you find this video helpful, then don't forget to drop a thumbs up. I would like to see how you're using the Weibel app in your project, so let me know in the comments. If you're into content like this, then make sure to subscribe and I'll see you in my next video.